Believe me, I'm known. party.
I'm sure they are.
Your sister-in-law seemed very happy.
Probably drunk. Woman drinks like a sieve. I can prove it. I got a picture of that too.
Maybe you'd feel better if you got stinking drunk.
I do not want to get stinking drunk.
My daddy always says the best way to overcome grief is to get stinking drunk.
What does he know about grief?
Well, he's seen a lot of it, so I guess he knows a lot.
Your daddy knew my Zachary?
Sort of.
What do you mean, sort of?
My daddy was the one who put the blue eyeshadow on. He's a mortician.
Oh my God. I'm talking to the mortician's daughter. That's me. Well, then,
didn't he?
I guess he thinks that's kind of
in this pickup being driven by my Uncle Jardine. I'm in the back with my cousin Richie and a couple of bales of hay. We're coming back from town and Richie's teasing me by moving the farms and daring me to do the same. So to prove I'm not some wicked dumb girl, I'm moving the farms too. We moon the cows, we moon the mailboxes. It gets so funny, it's painful. We can't stop laughing and crying. Then all of a sudden, Uncle John yells out, "You keep your asses in or you'll lose them." When we get back to the house and Aunt Louise calls us in and Uncle John takes the hay into the barn. It's late September and the barn's full of hay. Hay we used to play in all the time. And in between some of the rafters, we strung up this banner twine that we used to swing on at the bottom. Well, so happens that Uncle John takes the hay into the top floor of the barn. And it was dark and he must have tripped or something, because he fell through a hole in the floor, went straight to the bottom, and hung himself on the binding twine. Everyone was real upset. It was such a weird way to go. Then at the funeral, everybody's whispering how warm it was. And Uncle John's laying in his coffin, wearing too much rouge and eyeshadow and red lipstick. And Aunt Louise goes up to kiss him. And all she can say is, "My God, it looked like a screaming frog at the window." And I'm laughing. And Mama pinches me and tells me to shut up. And later on, there's this big speech at the wake. How someone's last words can sometimes be their most important. And when Mom asks me, "What's the last thing Uncle John said?" I'll tell her, "Keep your asses in or you'll lose them." She didn't believe me.
I think Elvis just turned over in his grave. That story is his by mile.
Well, that's the only one I know aside from Zachary.
Did he really say that thing about losing your asses?
God's truth.
Gosh, maybe there's a hidden message in that.
I doubt it.
I mean, they were his last words.
It doesn't mean anything.
What was the last thing Zachary said?
He called me a stupid bitch.
What?
We were having a fight, and he ended up calling me a stupid bitch.
What were you fighting about?
I wanted to adopt a baby. Zachary was against it.
Why?
I don't know why. He loved kids. He always wanted them. A year after we were married, I found out I couldn't have them. I couldn't have children. So Zachary went out and bought fish. Miles and miles of fish. Angelfish, goldfish, neon fish, Siamese fighting fish. You name it, he bought them. We must have had 10 aquariums in the house, every room except the bathroom. And every time I looked at them, they'd remind me how I couldn't have children. And how Zachary wanted children more than he wanted 10 aquariums for the fish. And they knew that too. The fish knew that. And they'd laugh at me. They'd swim around with their beady little eyes laughing at me.
How'd you know they were helping
them? They always bubbled every time I came close to
them. Maybe they were just trying to say hello.
Hello, my ass. They were laughing at me and I hated them. For years I hated them. They made me feel so bad inside. Half the time I wanted to explode. So when I finally decided I wanted to adopt a baby, I figured Zachary would be ecstatic. I figured we could finally get rid of the fish and start a real family. But he said I was too old. He said we were both too old. Anyway, he didn't want somebody else's kid, and he didn't want to get rid of the fish.
Is that when he said what he said to you?
No, that came later. We argued for a bit, and Zachary went out to the garage. I was so upset, I was running around the house trying to think of a way to get back at him, and then he came to me. I would get rid of the damn fish.
All of them.
So I made sure Zachary was still outside, and I started flushing him down the toilet. I did it, and I enjoyed it. I flushed 123 fish. How would I flush more? But the toilet clogs. Oh, yeah. I know. I could have found a plunger anywhere.
Oh, I mean the fish.
I wasn't thinking straight. I was so upset I didn't even hear him come up the stairs until he called me a stupid bitch.
When he saw all those fish in the toilet, he must have freaked.
He had a heart attack.
Oh, man.
No, I mean, he really had a heart attack.
What?
That's when he had the heart attack.
Did he die?
Right there in front of me. There wasn't even a minute to call for help.
Jesus, you killed him.
Please don't say that. That's probably what they're all saying in there, man. Beth, Roy, and the rest of them, all of them blaming me. I guess that's why I came out here.
I didn't mean it like that.
I wanted a family so badly. All I got was a dead husband and a bunch of dead fish. I keep repeating it over and over again in my head, and it still don't make no sense. I feel cheated.
I felt that way with Mom.
Cheated?
Yeah, and kind of guilty because my being born made her die.
That had nothing to do with you, honey. Couldn't prevent it.
It happened, and that's the way I always feel, like you and Zachary.
I guess. I sure as hell didn't know it to have a heart attack.
Now, the fish are a different story. You are definitely a fish murderer.
Don't remind me. I'm depressed enough as it is.
Look on the back side. At least they're in heaven with Zachary.
Oh, that wouldn't surprise me.
And Elvis is there, too.
Elvis.
And Mom.
And Uncle John D.
And Einstein and Humphrey Bogart and Walt Disney and J.H.C.
J.H.C.?
Jesus H. Christ.
Him too.
You ever get the feeling it's so lonely down here sometimes?
What do you mean?
Just that.
Sometimes, I guess. Sometimes it is.
Makes you kind of wonder if you're missing out on something.
Maybe.
I mean, what do you think they do up there?
Something tells me they watch over us, guide us.
You mean like right now?
Yeah, like right now. Zachary's probably looking down, wondering what I've been crying about. Still thinking I'm a stupid bitch, but loving me all the same. He did love me. I know he loved me.
I had a dream about heaven once. It was like this great big game show with a zillion prizes. Only it wasn't an ordinary game show, because in this one, everybody was a winner. Everybody. And no one actually got any of the prizes. They just kept getting the joy of winning them over and over and over again. And God, he looked just like Bob Barker.
Bob Barker?
Yeah. And when someone dies, he just yelled,
"Come on down!" Oh, when I woke up this morning, I said to myself, this is going to be one rotten day, and it was. All through the service, I thought I was going to be sick, right there in the pew in front of everybody. I wasn't sure what was worse, the thought of being sick all over my indoors, or the thought for the first time, really, truly alone.
Rotten days.
This was a real stinker, wasn't it? I didn't think I'd get through it.
But you did.
Yeah. I guess I did. Is my makeup running?
A little.
Now?
It's there.
Good.